Well, it was once the heart of San Diego's downtown, a bustling retail outlet. Now Horton Plaza is an active construction site. Work has been going on since July as the former retail outlet is now being remade into a tech campus. And joining us here on Fox 5 is Jennifer Van Grove from the San Diego Union-Tribune. Jennifer, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. And, you know, let's talk a little bit about what's happening. I think a lot of people see the construction in Horton Plaza. We know that it became a little bit stale over there. People were not shopping. What's happened since? Who's doing it, and exactly what can we expect?
Realistically, most people, they can't even see the construction. So you can actually walk through Horton Plaza right now, walk through all the levels. You won't even notice anything's happening unless you look inside. And so what's happening is we're in the midst of this transition. Stockdale Capital Partners, they're a Los Angeles-based developer. They came in, they bought the center last year from Westfield. They purchased it for $175 million. And they have this grandiose plan to turn it into a tech campus. So they want to keep retail on the ground floor, but above that, they want office space. In May, they went to city council. They got approval for their plan. It was a land use restriction, essentially, that got lifted, but they got the approval. And then in July, they started taking hammers inside of buildings, and that's kind of where we're at today. They're also planning Horton Plaza Park, which is on the same site. It's very confusing if you're down there. There actually is a distinction, though. Horton Plaza Park is owned by the city. Stockdale would like to lease it from the city and then kind of remake it so that people actually want to hang out there.
So that was the land use change that went
yes.
on. So a lot of like issues that kind of came up in trying to redevelop this area. Talk to me a little bit about Jimbo's. I know Jimbo's is one of the retailers in there,
yep.
and they sued the former developer, or the developer and the former
right.
owner.
Yes, yeah, so Jimbo's, they are over by the old Nordstrom building, and they have been there since 2012. And Jimbo Somek, the owner, he really felt in 2012 that Westfield, the previous owner, had committed to turning the mall into just this really great attraction. So he feels slighted by that. So he sued Westfield, later amended his complaint to sue Stockdale Capital Partners. They are moving forward. I talked to Jimbo last week. He plans to take this to court. I think a trial date is scheduled in February of next year. However, Stockdale feels like it can move forward with the tech campus no matter what happens with the Jimbo's.
So really, it could potentially, it doesn't mean it's going to get stalled at all.
We don't know. So there is a clause in the Jimbo's complaint where he could seek to block the development. He hasn't invoked that yet. So a judge hasn't gotten involved in that yet.
Well, and there's not just, retail, but there are also big places there, like 24-hour
right.
fitness, Jimbo's, Macy's. What's happening with them?
So actually, it's just Jimbo's, Macy's, 24-hour fitness, and I think the post office. So 24-hour fitness is at the bottom of the Nordstrom building, and Stockdale has really big plans for the Nordstrom building, and this is kind of like the anchor of their office campus. So they're gutting it right now. They would like to add four stories to it. In fact, they have to, according to what got approved by city council. And then, but during that process, they're gonna have to move 24-hour fitness, so they need to find a new location for them. And then Macy's, we really don't know what's happening. So one of their lawyers went to city council a couple months ago and kind of said, well, we haven't signed off on this plan yet, and that means we could potentially block the development. Both parties have been very quiet on that front. I don't believe that there's been an accord reached. That's why I think we're seeing just interior demolition right now.
In short, we talk about a tech campus. What can people expect? Like, they'll have retail on the bottom and a tech campus. I don't think people know what that is. And what is the timeline for that?
Yeah, so when I say retail, really what I mean is food and beverage and fitness concepts. So something really complementary to workers. A tech campus, you either have someone, I don't want to throw out names there, but of Apple's caliber, of Facebook's caliber, and we actually know that Apple, is interested in the San Diego market, come in and maybe lease either the Nordstrom building or the full site. And then it's primarily dedicated to workers, but Stockdale is really going after the tech market in particular because they believe that those clients, they've just grown out of San Francisco and the Bay Area. They need to go to a new place and potentially like start a new talent hub.
And so what is the timeline for something like that?
Well, their timeline, they say the timeline has not changed. Their timeline is to start exterior demolition beginning of next year, also get the lease done for Horton Plaza Park next year. They would like to have people occupying the tech campus by the end of next year.
And then there's going to be a park as well. There you
yes.
go. All right. Well, a lot to look forward to. And if you want to read more about this, you can go to the San Diego Union-Tribune. Jennifer Van Grove, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.